Let us take the next question. I'll read what is given here. A pulley is driven by flat belt running at a speed of 600 meters per minute and transmits 4 kilowatt, full stop. The coefficient of friction between belt and pulley is 0.3 and angle of lap is 160 degree. Find maximum tension in the belt. Now this is the question which we have. Whatever is given in this question, I will write that in the form of data first. It is given, a pulley is driven by flat belt running at a speed of 600 meters per minute. The speed of the flat belt is given in terms of velocity. Your velocity is 600 meters per minute. So we will convert this. This becomes 600 divided by 60 meters per second. So therefore V is equal to 10 meters per second. This is the linear velocity of the belt. Now it transmits 4 kilowatt. The coefficient of friction between the belt and pulley is 0.3. And angle of lap is 160 degree. So I'll convert it into radians. This comes out to be 2.79 radians. Next, the question is, we have to find out maximum tension in the belt. See, whenever they say that you have to calculate maximum tension, maximum tension is tension in tight side. So T1 is the unknown for us. Now this is the question where we have to calculate T1. Power is given, so we will start from the formula of power. Since power transmitted by belt drive, the power transmitted is given by P is equal to T1 minus T2 into velocity. I will keep this as first equation. Next, since mu and theta they are given, I will use the belt tension ratio. Belt tension ratio is given by T1 upon T2 is equal to e raised to mu theta. So it is equal to e raised to mu is given as 0.3, theta is 2.79. So from this I will get T1 is equal to, it is 2.31 into T2. Now once I have the relation, I'll keep this as my second equation, and then I know the value of power and velocity, so I'll say that put all values in equation number 1. Therefore power, it is given as 4 into 10 raised to 3. T1, I will write T1 in terms of T2, that is 2.31 T2 minus T2 into the velocity. Velocity is 10. So from this, if I calculate, I'll get the answer of T2 as 305.15 Newton. After getting T2, I will put the value of T2 in equation 2 to get the answer of T1. So I'll say that put T2 is equal to 305.15 Newton in equation number 2. Therefore T1, it is equal to 2.31 into T2, and T2 is 305.15. So from this I will get the answer of T1, that is 704.91 Newton, and this will be my final answer because in the question they have told to calculate maximum tension, and T1 is the answer of maximum tension. With this, we complete this question.